Yo, what's good? This Big Yip, and you kicking it with B-High on Gatlin All HipHop.com. Zaga.
In the building, I got an A-Town legend, Mr. Get Down himself. 1-4 for the Goody Mob, man. Big Gip, what's good with it, my dog?
What's going on, B? What's happening, man? We in the city, man. A-Town, what's going down?
I mean, welcome home, man. I know you're making your way between L.A. and the A-Town right
yeah,
about now.
Yeah, all the time, man. You know, I got a spot out there. I got a little honeycomb hideout. Yeah. You know, I keep a dugout in the A-Town all the time, man. You know, I got to keep the legs parked in the South, man.
Exactly.
Ain't nowhere else for them to be. What's happening with you?
I mean, nothing, but man, I want to get straight into this tape, though.
Let's do it.
Mr. Get Down, man.
Mr. Get Down, man.
Tell me about it. How all this come about? What made you decide to drop this mixtape, man? Because I know you don't normally fool with the tapes like that.
Yeah, well, what happened was I did my new deal with Epic Records, like right there at the end of, you know, 14.
Yeah.
And me and CeeLo put a record out called Shine Like Gold.
That's right.
And it was my first, you know, reintroduction back into the music business. I signed with Epic Records. I'm back home with Sylvia Rome and L.A. Reid. So I was happy. We put that record out. It was like a worldwide record. It came out. It charted top 20 in the UK, Australia, Japan.
Mm-hmm.
And then my little brother went on Twitter and said something, and then they pulled my record.
What was going through your mind when that hit the fan, man?
It's all good, man, because, you know, sometimes, man, we don't know what social media can do. You know what I mean? And we didn't know the laws and the things you shouldn't do. So, you know, we just learned from the situation. We not tripping. So what I did was, I didn't trip. I just went back into my laptop and I pulled all these songs that I had just laying in my laptop and said, let me just do a record for the streets so at least I can give them something, you know, before I drop the album. But it all came about after we did the Outkast, you know, week in Atlanta, the Outkast.
At last concert,
and just to see 30,000 people come out and see us from Friday to Saturday, which we brought over 100,000 people to the city, man, from all over the world to see us do our music together for the last time, man, and that was something that it really touched my heart. So that's what made me go into myself and say, man, what could I do for these fans, you know? Because the love they ain't given to us for 20 years, I had to get some back. So I went in and I gave them 18 new songs, man. Put it out like Thanksgiving Day, and we already got 100,000 downloads, getting ready to go on tour, all kind of stuff, man. You know what it is.
I mean, Boxed Up Shouty. I seen the visual for that thing. I mean, straight up dope. Tell me about how that came about.
Okay, Boxed Up Shouty, man. I just wanted to pull the lack back out and remind Atlanta what we built this city on. We built this city on old-fashioned and old styles and respect for the old, and you know, I just wanted to show people, man, Gip still can do that. You know, man, I can still do that. I can pull one of the legs out of storage, man, and drop the top and hit the air just to show people, man, I ain't never scared of my people. I'm always gonna make music for my people, but you know, the world is a big place, man, and I gotta go see it.
My favorite joint off that tape, though, man, that Sugar, Cocoa, and Honey with Bruno Mars.
Yeah.
I mean, tell me about how that one came about, boy.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, like, Bruno had recorded a few songs for Low.
Yeah.
And these were one of the records that were laying around that we had in the vault. Mm-hmm. And I said, hey, man, bro, you gonna use this record? He said, no. So, you know, I was like, hey, man, that Bruno Mars, you know. You know, he wasn't Bruno then, you know, he was their Bruno the session writer, you know what I mean? So I jumped right on it, man, and you know, already, man, the record already getting played in Africa, the UK, you know, Singapore, you know what I mean? It's getting played all over the world, and it's just a mixtape, you know, song. It wasn't even something that I put out there for sale. And you know, like, we got a new video. I put a new video out. Booty B, did by my dude named Caviar, man. I did that in the crib. That's just for all the folks in Atlanta, man. Go to the booty club, man. You know how we do it. We raised up off of it.
That's right.
I was in strip clubs 16 years old, man, over there in Montreal, man.
That's right.
So that was just something I did for the strippers. But I'm about to drop another record off the album, off the mixtape. It's called Paradise Life.
Yep.
Now this just stomped down Gip here. This just stomped down Cadillac music, man. You know, because when we came into the game, it was about having a record that you could jump in the car and ride around Atlanta all day, man.
Right.
One gas stop and the rest we gonna keep it rolling, you know.
Right.
So that's what this record all about, just reminding people of what we came up off of. It's cool to do the club stuff and all that kind of stuff, but you know, I just always been in the music that make me think. If it don't make me think or make me think of something better I can do it myself, then I can only listen to it for, you know, for service value.
That's right.
You know what I mean? So yeah, Paradise Life, that's the next thing. And then, yo man, I'm about to give up the drop the album. Yep. Zaga. You know,
now
epic.
Tell me about this album now.
This album, it's gonna be a musical journey. I feel like this album is the closest thing to Love Below, Outkast's last album, you know? Because one thing, me being from the dungeon, we got this, when we do albums, this is all about music.
That's
you
right.
know what I mean? It's a difference between doing a mixtape and doing an album. Mm-hmm. So when I'm doing an album, I'm trying to reach all kind of people. I'm trying to reach all kind of cultures. So what do you do when you try to do that? Yeah. You go and make great music. So the album is basically about me going in and showing you the diversity and the growth of Gip as an artist for, and you know, over 20 years, man, I showed you that I can be many faces. That's why I call myself the mutant, because, you know, yeah. I've been able to flip and be different characters in front of your face, and you have to be like, how you reinvent yourself like that? Well, it's an art to this, you know what I mean? And I'm trying to show artists that if you don't learn this, you will not survive as long as I've been able to survive.